Walking across the wobbly Vancouver Capilano Suspension Bridge. And look at this way down here, up there, and look over there. And there's a little deck, and there's Scott. There we are. Woohoo, it's very wobbly. It's going tipsing back and forth. So I'm hanging on to the handrail here. Signing off. Hello. There he is. He's talking to us. Let's see if he does it again.
He's going to make that noise every 7 seconds.
Every 7 seconds. There he is.
What time is it,
Kane? I'm telling you. 12:20.
What is it about 7 seconds?
I actually have no idea why he does it every 7 seconds, and I never counted it, but this one kid was like so pumped the bird was talking. And I was like, if you just paid attention when you first approached, you would notice the bird was making noise every 7 seconds. And then the kid counted it, and he's like, damn, it is every 7 seconds. And I was like, oh, that's interesting. I guess my subconscious counted it one day. So I had no idea it was every 7 seconds.
We are in Vancouver on our dinner cruise. It's downtown Vancouver. An island gas station.
We're currently traveling to the waters of Pearl Harbor, once a popular spot among Squamish people for fishing herring. It gained its name from the underwater coral deposits discovered here in the 1850s. Also, on the right-hand side, is the expansion of the Vancouver Convention Center. The building triples the size of the original. They now share 500,000 square feet of meeting space. It is one of the largest conference spaces in the country. It's
and there, we went to the top of that this morning. Took pictures from the top of that tower.
It's kind of weird, actually.
Starting?
Cheers. We are on the Harbor Cruise in Vancouver. Ready to leave? Alright, this is the Lions Gate Bridge, suspension bridge, built by the Guinness family, which is the equivalent of the Rockefellers of New York. So the Guinness family of Vancouver built this, and they also have own a lot of buildings downtown in Vancouver. So here is a lighthouse standing at the edge there. Whoa, zoom in. And along this whole area is a bike trails. I don't know if you can see bikers along there, but yeah, all along this area is a bike trail. Bikes and bike around it or take a tour. So look at all the ships out there. There's a lot of ships. Let's see if I can. This way. Oh, this is, I believe this is Grouse Mountain. And the Capilano Suspension Bridge is on the other side of Lions Gate. So that's where we went on our tour today. Went over the bridge. There's Scott. We're riding bikes today around Stanley Park. And room over here. This is the Vancouver version of The Little Mermaid, but it's not called The Little Mermaid. It's called Girl in Wetsuit. So she does have flippers on. But it looks like The Little Mermaid. Called the Lions Gate Bridge. You know the movies, at the end of the movies they have the Lions Gate symbol. Well, this is where it came from. So this is a suspension bridge built by the Guinness family, who owns the beer company. So we'll be riding around Stanley Park on the other side of the bridge. And this is, I don't know if I can zoom in, but I see an airplane up there. They give Harbor to an airplane tour. Vancouver. There's an airplane flying up there. Anyway, this is North Vancouver. And here's the rest of Stanley Park. Got off our bikes. We're on the beach by Stanley Park, and here's Scott, and then here I am. Here's the beach, and I am going to dip my toe in the Pacific Ocean. Beach people. So here we go. Okay, cool. There's my feet in the Pacific Ocean. It's cold. Woo-hoo. Yeah. So there we go. Rocky Mountaineer train 2023? 23rd. 23rd, okay. And there is our car, J01. There's the downstairs dining room. We're going upstairs to our seats on the gold leaf dome car.
Hi there, good morning.
Good morning. We're on 11 and 12.
11 and 12, you're right here.
Oh, right here, yeah. Okay. Here we are.
Well, then I'm in your seats. This is 9 and 10 here.
I'm Scott. We're right by the stairs, right here.
Hi, how are you?
So here's the gold leaf.
How are you?
So your seat's 18 and 17.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're kind of at the back of the...
Here we go.
Just under the windows for 17.
There's the golden code.
All right, so our lovely destinations team here on our right side waving us off to say goodbye. Now you think this is the end of it, but normally there are a few destinations hosts hiding in the bushes just right here. There we go, our wild ones. Lovely.
Yeah, this is the, I think she said the Portland Bridge is the widest cable-supported bridge in North America. It's 10 lanes wide. So here's the cable, and as we go under it, here's the Fraser River, by the way. We're in the biggest rail yard in Vancouver right now. But anyway, here's the 10 lane, 5 lanes on each side. 10 lane cable supported bridge. Biggest, widest one in North America. And it goes over the Fraser River. So there it is. They store the logs in the Fraser River freshwater because the freshwater preserves the logs, preserves the wood. So that's why they keep it in the water. You can see, yeah, it's also free to store it in the water. I don't know if you can see that, but there's logs.
Dangerous, because obviously if you fall through or one of them moves. Have you all seen them?
Those are log rollers. They're rolling the logs so that the logs get preserved in the fresh water. Logs being transported down the river. We're going over the bridge of the Fraser River.
And it is quite remarkable when you think about this. It's fairly rigid, right?
Camera.
And on some of the corners, like here, you can see the tight turns that they're having to maneuver these locks. So they are broken up into sections, so you do have some flex. But it's quite incredible to watch them try to maneuver around.
There's Mount Baker, and that's actually
where they actually had 95 feet of snow in one winter.
That's the United States.
We're actually very lucky
Canada,
to get such a such incredible
Mount
view
Baker
of
there, in the United States.
So that's Mount Baker in Washington State. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're coming up on one of the highlights of today. So this is called Cisco Crossing. So what I referred to earlier as when the Canadian National Railway was built 30 years before, this is a... So make sure you're looking out both sides as we come over. As we look out to the left, you have a beautiful view of this orange bridge. So like I said before, that's the Canadian National Bridge.
Canadian National Bridge.
Going west.
Go. Oh, gotta look on the other
side. There we go. Oh, there we go. And if you look down, you can see why the name muddled or confused for the waterway makes sense. And this is the only spot, ladies and gentlemen, on our journey where the Canadian National and the Canadian Pacific railways actually cross directly over each other. So you'll see as we come under here, we'll go under the Canadian National line. And here we have a great view just looking backwards right
down the
stream itself. So you'll see right down the Fraser. You have a beautiful view there as well.
Just passed a train way down there. Now we're coming up here. And what time is it? It is 1:49 on Monday. No, Tuesday. 23rd. So there's a little highway down there. Look at those rapids. Oh boy.
Another train, Canadian Pacific. So you can see it's pretty busy today, westbound. And
wow,
we have
a long train.
River, look right down there, ladies and gentlemen, we have a raft.
Oh, there's a raft here.
Just in the middle of the river.
Yeah, that's right. He's a sightseer.
did it. You did well.
There's some more rafters.
There's just, I really love this falls because you get the sense of the different colors as well. The red.
Over 100 years old, and that bridge there, that is the Wallachien Bridge. So we are getting the
14-year-old.
Gate. It is a very narrow drop down in the river. That is what's making these Murchison Rapids here. And you can see just how narrow it really is. And you'll get another view again where I am. So it's coming to the back of you. There you are. You should all be starting to get a view. It's coming to those in the back now. But that is Little Hell's Gate. So thankfully they did manage to get their canoe off to the side there thanks to one of those rocks that stopped.
Here, and take a video. It's going, just blend. Wow. Look at those falls. Holy cow. On the way from Jasper to Lake Louise, and we stopped at Athabasca Falls. This is the Athabasca River, and here is the falls. So we're gonna walk down here. Down a little farther in the falls. I don't know if you can see that. A little eddy in there. And then here we are on the bridge. We came down that bridge, and then there's some falls on the other side. Wow. You can see my shadow, right? Shadow. Lake Louise. Here is the lake, and this was named after Queen Victoria's fourth daughter, Louise Caroline Alberta. And the first chalet here was in 1890 or 1884. There's a little walkway to the restrooms, and here is the Fairmount Lake Louise Chateau. There's the river coming out of the lake. It's kind of rainy. It was nice this morning, but now it's rainy. So anyway, beautiful lake. You can hardly see the mountains because it's cloudy, but this morning it was beautiful. Signing off. Here we are at the Chateau Lake Louise. Here's the hotel. It stopped raining. So what time is it? It's about 1:15 right now. Here is the beautiful lake. Look at the pretty color. Look at the mountains and the clouds up there. We gotta go catch up with Scott here on the trail. Signing off. Okay, here we are hiking around Lake Louise. Here is the Lake Louise Chalet Fairmount. Zoom back. Okay, so we're hiking down this trail here. Look at the mountains. I'll just pan around here into the sun. What time is it?
It is
1:36.
1:30, okay. And then we're going to go down here. Look at those snow-capped mountains up there. So we're on our way. Here we are hiking up around Lake Louise in Alberta, Canada. There's some hikers down here. I don't know if you can see all this. Hopefully it'll come through on the video. We just hiked from down there. And now we're just going uphill a little bit. Then we have to be back in an hour to go to our shuttle to Banff. Hiking back to Chateau Lake Louise. There's Scott. Let me zoom in on Chateau Lake Louise. There it is. Wow, it's pretty big. Not like Fairmount Jasper. Fairmount Jasper has cabins, but Fairmount Lake Louise has hotels. Again, I am just going to pan this area. High mountains. Looking into the sun. There's snow up there. Lots of snow. And looking over here, there's some people in a shallower area. And we are over there, and we're going back to catch the van to Banff.
Oh. Get out of here.
This is black and red.